Hi everybody and long time no see, but today I'm here to share with you some great news. So, for the last several years, we've been working hard on a complete Flexmonster reboot, and today we are ready to share a first look. So, this release is all about making the reporting process better, faster, and more efficient. As a team that's been working in data analytics for years, we know the pain like no one else. Each year, more and more companies face the fact that the amount of data they need to process increases exponentially. And processing large datasets at full capacity slows everything down. Long server response times, freezing UIs, wasted minutes, or even hours. If you've ever worked with massive datasets, you know the struggle. We've tackled all of these pain points head on. And the results? Well, let's just see for ourselves. We've been working with data processing optimization for several releases already. So our component uses Flexmonster data server for better performance, and it was available in previous versions also. In Flexmonster 3.0, we reimagined the whole thing. The new architecture optimizes how data is stored, acquired, and transferred, minimizing response times and keeping the UI smooth even with millions of rows. And with new features, it also greatly increases the volumes of data it can process at such speed. We really aim to take a great step forward by improving the whole reporting process. So we wanted to compare it to the alternatives on the market, and for this purpose, we chose the mastodon of reporting, Excel. Well, having one of the broadest functionalities besides others, working with big datasets can be a struggle with this tool. You can think that it's a bit odd to compare these tools as they differ in many ways. But what we wanted to show is that a web component is totally capable of performing better than an app that has access to all of the computer's resources, including CPU, memory, and direct access to the data source. Let's see how Excel handles this 150 megabyte file. Once again, Excel sends an alert that the file has too many records and cannot be fully displayed. The higher limit is a little bit over 1 million records. But for such situations, Excel has a special add-on that's called Power Pivot. It has a bit more power and can handle that task. But even for Power Pivot, it takes more than 1 minute to load and display the file. Now let's scroll and see if we can see all 5.6 million records. And yes, we do. Though the UI is lagging and stuttering and a bit when you scroll too fast. But if we switch to Flexmonster, we'll see that loading and UI interaction goes smoothly and really fast. You can't even notice it. Amazing results on the client side and equally cool with the server optimization. With all that server optimization, we managed to achieve a loading time of 8 seconds for a 154 megabyte compared to 1 minute in Excel. Now, when you have loaded it once to the server, you can instantly see your data on the grid with each new request as well. Look how smoothly and perfectly the scroll works even with such an enormous amount of data. The UI works instantly and displays everything you want just in one click. Now, let's change the slice and see how our grid can handle that. So, we apply some changes and wow, you can't even notice that something changed. The performance is still perfect. So, let's raise the stakes. Now we will take 1.6 gigabyte file. It would have taken more than 5 minutes for Excel to load this file. But don't worry, we will speed up the timer. But even using the power pivot feature in Excel doesn't solve the problem with stuttering and lagging of the grid when you scroll through all this amount of data. Now, let's see how Flexmonster can handle this task. So here you can see us loading the file with the dataset into Flexmonster. As you can see, the server loads the file in 1 to 2 minutes. So let's interact with it to see that the whole file and not just the first several records are displayed. So, did you notice it? I'll give you several seconds to think and rewatch. Yes, there is zero waiting time, and on the client side, you can instantly interact with the data without any UI lag. And that is totally outstanding result. Such a big file loaded fast with 11 million rows. Smooth scrolling through millions of rows. No UI lags. Zero frustration. But why are we showing this on a flat table? Because it's the most challenging scenario. Don't worry, pivot mode performs just as smoothly. But in a flat form, each and every record must be displayed and loaded on the grid. So it gave us an opportunity to show the full potential of the component. And it gives an understandable comparison with Excel. All right, let's push it to the limit. 31 gigabytes of data. How can you handle them? And here is something fascinating. Our new architecture reduces the memory footprint. So a 31 gigabyte dataset only takes 13 gigabytes in memory, meaning better resource efficiency for your server. And again, for the client side, interaction is still instant. Millions of rows, instant scrolling, no UI lags. So what does this all mean? It doesn't matter how much data you're working with, your clients will never have to wait. No slow UI, no endless loading times, just instant access and smooth performance. So let's see how many rows are in this 31 gigabyte file. And the number is more than 82 million of rows. Looking back at every test we performed, did you notice the sizes of the files we worked with? In Flexmonster 3.0, we also focused on maximizing the data volumes our component is capable of processing. That means a total increase in data size. Instead of a limit of 1 gigabyte, we are now moving to tens of gigabytes. And the results are obvious. We managed to extend the amount of data enormously without losing performance or data loading speed. That's what Flexmonster 3.0 is about. Analyzing more data, faster and better. Instead of waiting for your data, you can focus on what really matters. Making better decisions, optimizing processes, and maybe even spending a little more time with your family. So that's all what we have for you by now. But that's not the end. We continue to work on the release and new features and we'll update you as they go live. But for now, we strive for your feedback. Your ideas and thoughts can help us shape the final release. So let us know what you think in the comments below or reach out directly. We would love to hear from you. So see you in the next videos and bye!